Wowza, wowza, wowza. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Stream Many Things. My name is Wheeler. I'm your host for tonight. And before we get started, we got a few quick things to get out of the way. One, if you aren't already following the channel, please do. If you have the financial ability to, please consider subscribing. Don't forget that we are doing a fundraiser for Planned Parenthood ongoing until we hit the goal. I don't care how long it takes. We're going to make sure that people have access to safe and affordable health care. And yeah. Other than that, if you aren't following us on our socials already, please do at StreamMMT on Twitter, TikTok, and Instagram. Or you can find me specifically at Really_Wheeler or Wheeler's Minis, where I do things. If you haven't already checked out my website, please do www.wheelersminis.com, where I have stuff in stock at the moment that I am selling. And some of the stuff that might be finished tonight might be up in the store. So, yeah. Thank you guys for your continued support. Thank you for giving me the ability to take January off so I could get rest and recuperate. I hope you guys had a great start to the year so far. And yeah, we're going to go ahead and get started with the good old mini paint chill. Oh, I forgot. If you aren't already subscribed to our YouTube channel, please do that. It is free. And I've got a bunch of goals that I want to get to this year. We're already 2 months in, so hopefully we can get to them. But yeah. Thank you guys for joining. And I hope you guys enjoy. If you have anything that you have questions about or just want to chat, feel free to enter that into the chat for me. Where's the... Oh, there you are. All right. So some stuff I'm working on for home game stuff / commission stuff. Some stuff I'm working on for the store. This guy's got some paint on him already, but I think I will save him. I've got this druid I could also start work on, and then the bases for things. Let's get some color on these because I primed them. I need some good old high purple. And I will need some purple alchemy. All right. Go back up here. And then get some purple on him. Using my airbrush to prime things, and I decided to start priming in black because I think that it looks better. It also gives a little bit more shadow to things just right off the bat. I should start selling the is printed stuff so people can paint them on their own, since I know that not everyone prefers my art. Completely okay. If you have any recommendations or thoughts on the matter, please let me know. Constantly putting polls up. And for our return, I'm probably going to set up a community challenge to see if we can get to a certain amount of points so we can pick a big mini again. It seems to be a common theme of enjoyment. It's purple on that for now. We're going to do purple on all the bits here that are like tentacles. And then the quote-unquote purple alchemy that's more of a pink. I'm going to do that on the brain itself. Been a while since I've been able to do this on stream. I've been painting and printing my own time at home. But it's nice to be back and making content again. We're going to be doing this twice a week now. It's just the more popular and more watched videos on the channel. So I want to make sure that I'm making more of that content for you. And now that I have a store open, it does help make sure that I'm at least painting sometimes during the week to ensure that I have stock for said store, which is kind of important when you're running a business to have stock. So but also just for personal projects, stuff like this. The other thing too about priming and doing Zenithal is that when I get speed paint like this on the model, it already kind of shows a nice variable level of shading, which is kind of what I was hoping for, which is nice. You guys voted on it, more humanoids coming in 2023 to the store, so. Just have to get stuff printed out and on the store. Debating whether I'm gonna do these little spikes. I think I'm also gonna do in the darker purple to kind of tie in the rest. I think it looks good.
So that's that purple. Move on to the purple. Oops. Stealing some of the...
Beautiful. For this base as well, I'm gonna go with purple, because like aberration stuff is like a purplish, it's got like a purplish tint to it. I'm gonna probably go over it in like black and then hit it with like a gloss to give it kind of that weird like membranous aspect, but it's gonna have a purple undertone. Honestly, I'll probably do just purple all over him too, because similar to that, the clothing that they wear is also kind of It's got a purple undertone to it. Because, like, some of this is going to be more, like, of a metallic look, but I still think that the purple undertones are going to assist with what I'm trying to grab with this. Even if it's metal, metal already has a dark undertone to it, so I don't mind really hitting it up more. Up with the purple are the skulls on the side and kind of part of the utility belt, so to speak. Grab more. I'm just trying to be better about making sure that this doesn't stay in there. Oh! Thank you.
go for the green.
Yeah, I like this green color. Nice. Maybe a nice little, like, grotesque green. That'll go nicely with the purple and pink, I think. Those dry. I will start working on, first and foremost, some earth color so we can get some color on the branches. And then I will need a, it's too deep of a green. Stay Wild Emerald should be good for her. Base. I think I'm gonna do ruddy skin, honestly. Getting some new color on the roots that this druid is summoning. Thank you. and her staff for that matter, because her staff is also made of wood. Really just getting some more texture on these pieces. I might add a little bit of green to the tips to kind of mimic that kind of idea of growth.
As if you literally don't see me all the time, but thank you. It has been some time since I've done this, and I'm excited to get back into it. I genuinely did miss doing... No! That's okay. The staff is just going to be a little bit shorter. I genuinely did miss doing this. Hard to break the mold. This is supposed to be a female druid. It's a little hard to break the mold of like green and brown when it comes to druids. And I don't want it to exactly just look like, you know, certain other redhead female druids out there. But I just think that honestly it's a good color scheme for it, and it's difficult to break away from that when it's already such a good color scheme. I'm gonna make her a little bit darker skin toned than Keyleth, but it's gonna still end up looking like that. Alright, now take some this. Oh yeah. Well, I'm glad you missed it. Like I said, I have two. It's been some time since I've been able to do it, and of my own volition, but I am glad to get back into it. And seeing as, you know, this is going to be the mainstream forum, at least for a bit, I am excited to see what doing this twice a week does for my stock on the website. So right now I'm just getting some green on here to make it look like it's new growth coming at the tips, and that's just going to give it that sense of like growing out. And then put some green on her skirt, which is good. Now skin tone. Start working that in. Actually, I might need a near brush for this.
gonna work over that amulet that she's wearing for now. I can always paint back over that. Get skipped.
Yeah. It's a smaller brush.
Whew. Probably going to use a couple of coats of skin tone to get the tone that I'm looking for. Fine. Two thin coats is better than one too thick coat. I'm excited. More humanoids in the store is always a good thing. That's kind of what people have requested, so trying to do more humanoid-like. And since I finished Maeve and actually got to take a picture of her, put it up, now people have a reference for my skills when it comes to humanoids. Hopefully this is just something that's going to add to it. Little filigree on her is going to be gold. Yeah, and green and gold is just a good color combo. Brushes that I have. I What's her skin down? I know I want like a darker. I guess a leather brown would work for this leather brown, not the
yellowish leather brown.
Use this brown for her. Luckily, I'm gonna go over this with like flush shade and stuff, so even if it does match color a little too much right now, it'll change in tone once I put the earth shade and flush shade on. Monster, which is nice, like auburn. Hydrate or dehydrate? Give me a second. I left my water bottle out of the room, so I will return momentarily with it as soon as I'm finished getting this bone color on these antlers. Thank you for joining, and thank you for reminding me that I need to drink water. It is very important. We'll be right back. Alright, I will return momentarily with my water bottle. Some water. Hydration, it's key. Let's see what's next. Or here, probably. I think that's wood. That's connecting the antlers on the outside, but I will do that when I get a little bit more into the detail. For now, I'm just kind of getting paint on the mini. And I can always go back over things and I accidentally painted the wrong color. Hair is officially orange. Thank you. if I'm not talking as much. I tend to get very focused when I'm doing this, so I appreciate the patience. What I did for her before I started painting her on here was I just put some speed paint on her based off of what colors I think I was going to use, or I thought I was going to use, when I was painting her. So obviously kind of a skin tone for the skin, an orange for the hair, a bone for kind of the head and mantle. You know, stuff like that. And what that does is just give me a good foundation to work off of. So that way, as I'm painting, the shadow is already there. Anything that I do is going to basically keep the same color underneath. And we're getting into some more detail work, so I need a little bit of bronze. Brushes that I got for Christmas. My very good friend and lovely player got me some sable brushes, and I have been loving them. They are oh so very nice. So, since I almost done with getting a base coat on, and the next piece is just going to be getting detail and then shading. to it. Can shade these with an oil to really help bring out the depth of the metal. Parts are, 100% wood. of beans. Alright. We've got that. Do so. Shading in a second. First, just want to double check. Got everything. All right, and then this will be for the lips. Should be able to do shading. Oops. Thank you.
Okay, next. Would do normal oil on metal bits, but seeing as she's nature based, I might do brown. Because I think it might give it a better, more cohesive look. I did it in brown. I think that's what I'm gonna do.
Right here.
Thank you.
checking the time. It goes by fast. When you're enjoying what you're doing. It's been nice to be able to get back to like focusing on something. Focusing on literally everything. Alright, now they just let this dry for a bit. And I can get back to it once it's dry. In the meantime though, let's take a look at... Very cool. More of the actual pink. So I think I had one called like Pixie Pink or something. Pixie Dust Pink, yep. What's this up? Okay. What's pigments mixed in with the medium. And now it's actual paint rather than just probably way more than I need, but I'm
want to double check. So I might do like a where's my dragon? I do like a little bit of this with it to see if that mixes well or not.
So good.
Like, I need you, I know you're painting and you're doing something and you're like actively streaming right now, but I need you to try.
Alright, give me one second. Trying to get a good balance of these two colors.
Oh, beautiful. That is like the exact color I wanted. And I don't know why I am decently good at blending colors like this, but just it is a somewhat skill at this point. Take a quick break to eat some of this delicious, delicious food that my wife made. So good. If you can find a partner that cooks for you, you're set for life. I'll tell you. Boom. Love it. Beautiful. Chicken mural. Mostly dry. Ooh, getting the nitty gritty. It's always fun, though. Rope painted. What I did was basically a light brown to start the roof, and then the top I just go over it with bone. And all that's going to do is just make sure that there is a nice delineation between the bone and the rope, but it's going to give it that like rope look. So making sure that some of these bits have the colors they need on them to actually match what they are. I'm focusing on this now because the rest of it's going to be pretty simple. I just have to delicious thing I've ever had.
Did you like the mushy?
Yeah.
I tried a completely new process when making them, so I was hoping it
definitely did.
There is unfortunately not enough. I literally only got one because I need to make sure you have enough food. I love you.
I appreciate it. Just making sure that Everything's as it should be. The colors are where they need to be. At least for the skin and the top half. And it does look like they are. So now I can go back and focus on all of the branches. And then I'm probably going to make her eyes glow. Which the best way to do that is with a little bit of white. You do not need a lot. You actually need very, very little. Like it, which looks good, and probably just picks up the piece right there. Skin tone. So you start with white, and then you put like a contrast paint over it, and it looks like it's glowing. Symbolize her
you know what I'm trying to say.
Symbolize her I actually can't think of what I'm trying to say. Her attunement to nature. Her innate connection. pretty close to the end. Just got a few more small things I need to get done. And then she looks pretty good. All right, then for the green, we'll do a little bit of orc skin. Which is the most probably verdant green that I have.
We are going with you.
Green's kind of glowing out. Yeah.
Looks a little bit yellow.
Yeah.
It's pointed right here, so maybe
okay. Green, and that looks good, that looks good.
Thank you.
in some highlights now to better make some of the colors pop. Good. And just in time for the end. But yeah, I think she's done. It looks pretty good. I'm very happy. Hair looks good. Stuff on the top of the head looks good. The mantle looks good. Yeah. I think she's done. Well, she's definitely going up on the website, so. Congrats to whoever ends up nabbing her. I like the way the branches look, I like the green with the tips to kind of show that growth. Yeah, I think she looks pretty good. All right, well, put that good old matte finish on her and then we'll be good to go. In the meantime, thank you guys for joining. Thank you for being a part of our first stream back. A few quick things to get out of the way before we end for the night. One, if you aren't already following the channel, please do. If you have the financial ability to, please consider subscribing. Don't forget that you can subscribe for free to one Twitch channel per month with a Twitch Prime subscription. And on top of all of that, if you aren't already following us on our socials, you can do so at StreamOfNT on Twitter, TikTok, and Instagram. Don't forget to go to our YouTube channel and subscribe there. It's free. But other than that, I hope you guys had a good time. I hope you enjoyed the painting. We'll be back on Thursday for some more. So thank you so much for joining, and I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of the week and night. And like I said, I'll see you on Thursday. Same bat time, same bat channel. All right. Bye, guys.